So about follow-up emails, what needs to be understand, like what people need to understand is that's not that resending the same email that you'd previously sent or just saying, hey, I had applied for an internship and I would like to know my status. It's much more beyond that. Your follow-up email actually is that on so-and-so date, I sent an email regarding seeking an internship under your law firm from this date to this date. I am writing this email to inquire about whether internship is available in the set dates or whether there are alternate dates that I could intern with. To give a brief, when you talk about again a bit parts of your email that you had sent, you just give a brief, like you summarize that, and then you say, looking forward to hearing back from you. I've reattached my materials and thank you for the consideration. So that's what a follow-up email is, following up properly. It's not just, I had applied and kindly revert back to me kind of thing.
Yeah. And do follow up. And people ask me what happens if I don't follow up. If I get a bad response, if somebody gets angry, still follow up. If they are really pissed off with you, they'll tell you. And don't feel bad about that. Because trust me, more often than not, people need to be reminded. Go ahead.
I mean, now that I'm working and I get a lot of requests on LinkedIn, on messages on LinkedIn. And there are times when I've completely like forgotten that, okay, I'd opened the message and I've not replied yet.
Yeah, the biggest problem is if a busy person opens a message and forgets to reply. Because then that message won't pop up in their inbox or LinkedIn inbox or their WhatsApp again.
Exactly. So I think sending that follow-up really matters. And be persistent with your follow-up. It doesn't matter. Just make sure you're not following up after every 2 days. I mean, give them like the first email you send, then give like a 2-week timeline for them to reply. If they don't respond, then send a follow-up email. Then reduce it down to like probably like 8 days or 10 days and so forth. But be persistent in your follow-ups unless they say, please go away and don't email me again.
Yeah, and I actually suggest an offbeat technique for follow-up, which is this, that whenever you follow up with something new. So add in something new that you did. Add in a video CV. Add in something new that you published. Maybe say this, that, you know, I recently got 1,000 likes on my first article, on my next article, and this might be relevant to this deal that the firm worked on. Okay, and I was inspired by that and I thought I'd write something. You might want to have a look. And if you're not getting any responses, then I think you should just write one article. This is something I suggest, or one email with the headline, challenges faced by law firms in selecting the right candidate. Okay, like make something creative. Okay, so that's the person who's reading it, opens it, and then you can write in a postscript that actually I had applied for an internship and I just thought that this would make your job easier. I wanted to help. Okay, and obviously somebody can be really angry with that how dare you tell me how to do my job, but they'll also appreciate the effort that you took to make their life easier and to what length you can go to make it to be like creative. And I think that really counts.
Exactly, and I think if you still don't get a response, I always believe in reaching out to someone on LinkedIn or like at least in US, their email IDs are published on their website. So I always reach out to someone else, or I reach out to that same person on LinkedIn who I'm applying to or who I'm sending my materials to, saying that, hey, I'd sent a particular request and all. But when I approach them on LinkedIn, of course, I don't say that I want to intern with you and like I want to work with you and I sent an email. Just like, hope you're doing well. This is in reference to an email that I had sent on so-and-so date. And I would love to have a conversation with you anytime that is most convenient for you. Like an informational interview.
Yeah.
So when you're doing a follow-up as an informational interview, right, with the reference that I had emailed earlier, regarding an internship or a job application, it makes it a lot more easier because the person knows that, okay, this person is constantly asking because they have applied for a particular position and that's what they need help with. So I think that follow-ups also help a lot. I don't know how much they help.